For June 24, 2009, the Nigerian federal government may officially open one two-month amnesty window from 6 August to go reach October 4, 2009 to all militants for the Niger Delta region to take exchange for their demobilization plus disarmament. As they take surrender their weapons, the militants then been supposed to collect financial compensation from the government on top of a very period of time. The declaration for amnesty from President Mari Musa YAR'ADUA been follow recommendation where been they contained for the 2008 report from the NDTC. The committee being initially established by the federal government to take check plenty initiative we then take for the Niger Delta region and to take summer comprehensive report plus a recommendation. To follow us discuss this matter, na Ambassador Boladei Igali will be leader for Niger Delta region via Skype. Good morning, sir. Ambassador, good morning, sir.
How are you today?
We're full ground. So I want to just ask you one small question. We concern this matter. What are these arrangements? These arrangements, whether it really stopped the wahala way being dead in Niger Delta?
Well, yes, if they hear me.
Yeah, they hear you.
Okay, sorry for the interruption. Well, 2007, before President YAR'ADUA came in,
okay,
that time we get plenty problem for Niger Delta. Our boy is on vex. The eye is on red.
So
eye is on red because they say the way they take do the oil industry, they don't like them. They know they employ our people. They know they give work to our boys. They know they consider us for anything. Okay. Development not there. Number two, that time the whole Asare Dokobo, he did under prison, the whole DSP Alamesia. Obasanjo then to appoint me as honorary advisor to go around all the camp to tell the boys to calm down, saying we'll do something. So now why would they go around to come see, say, one of the problems, the problem of law and justice. Save them, just bring out these boys. Police should begin to arrest them anyhow. So on the 27th of February 2007, for that meeting, then they call presidential meeting on coastal states of Niger Delta for Villa.
Okay.
There I can't relieve the story. Say, Mr. President, you know, if you get any progress until you give amnesty to these boys.
Okay.
They all scatter, everybody happy.
So
from that time, election can't take place. YAR'ADUA can't win as president. So YAR'ADUA invite me and Professor Tekena Tamuna, we don't die.
Okay.
We'll be professor of history for University of Ibadan. Two of us. Three times invite us. Say we can't tell them. How we take do that amnesty. We will tell them everything. Say first and foremost, we will allow boys when they're ready to work with government to submit their weapons.
Okay.
After that, you will declare. Say you're not going to do anything to anybody. Because you know, say when boys vex like that, then do we'll not go agree. With their carry gun. Some bad things will happen. And police will hold them. Army will hold them. SSS will hold them. So that's why that discussion can't continue from that time until finally in 2009, President YAR'ADUA can't declare the amnesty.
Okay.
For them.
Okay, so this
now the amnesty. Amnesty get three parts.
Okay, okay.
According to the committee, we've been talking about how amnesty will be. What they call the Ledo Meter Committee. One part, not to allow this boy say, make everybody come out from all the camps. That time, I visit 32 camps.
Okay.
Different places, some day inside ocean with my team. For my own time, 2007. They made them come out. Nobody could do anything.
Okay.
Number two, they go train these boys, train them on different trades.
Okay.
And other boys from Niger Delta will know they do anything. So that they will get something to do with their hand.
Okay.
So that some then oil companies will take them, some will start their business, other ones, them. free do other thing where they go free do trade.
Okay, so ambassador, this government now, as they share,
some of them will employ them for companies.
Okay, ambassador, can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
You hear me? So this government, as they share the money, it really can't bring peace to the region. It really,
yes.
The money we then share that time, I want to know that it really bring peace to the region.
They're not share money. That's the one thing I want to correct. They're not share money.
Okay.
Nobody they share money. Mm. There were three components in that, like at the top. Number one, I wait and they call DDR, demobilization.
Okay.
We then go demobilize these boys.
Okay.
Then they go come, allow them, train them to do something with themselves. Number two, now the aspect of the infrastructural development of Niger Delta, we they never touch at all. Number three, now the environmental remediation. That is, they go correct this environment because the way they don't pollute the Niger Delta, somebody call them, say, ecological disaster, ecological terrorism. Mm. They don't scatter our environment. That's enough to go farm. Now, federal government, this government don't start with Ogoni.
Mm.
Whether they go feed do small things for Ogoni. But Ogoni is a small part of Niger Delta.
Okay.
So we never really see action for the environmental. We never see action for the infrastructure development. East-West Road, listen to me. To the East-West Road, Nakila.
Okay.
Many parts of East-West Road not good.
Okay.
But the part where concern these boys, where they ask so that the money don't bring peace.
Yeah.
That money, they know they share.
Okay.
Now, money where these boys, they are training them, and as they train them, most of them is money given to them as training allowance.
Okay, training allowance. Okay, good, Ambassador. So why can't be same? Why? Because of time, I can just ask
those don't come out from training.
Okay. Because of time, I can just ask you this last question. So why you be say they recommend where the Niger Delta Technical Committee, NDTC, give, it only they partially implement, they no finish work for the matter?
My sister, it's a matter of political will.
Okay.
They don't implement the first part. The first part, now these boys will drop gun.
Okay.
They say, okay, make we train on that. So that money where then they pay. And the money for training of the now some of them don't finish training.
Okay.
Agreement to help you give you to start up. So they them.
Okay.
Because they never still give them job, they never still find things for them to start up. That's why some of those they train, and they still pay them. Now the other two parts, the part for the environment, the part for the infrastructure development. Now, political will. We don't have to wait until this boy that carry gun again.
Okay.
I go be say from where oil they come. East West Road. Look, that East West Road now only about oil production.
Okay.
You go do it, we go do like road for America. You go find past all the road for the world.
Okay.
But they don't want to do it. So you have to implement the pathway concerning the infrastructure of the road. There are major roads where they never do. Bayelsa State government, they struggle. The coastal road, road to for the Delta local government. All this is not something it's supposed to do. All these are major oil producing area.
Not true.
3 days of oil production to do the road.
Not true. Not true, Ambassador. Everything so where you...
When you open all this road, nowhere for any criminals.
Yeah.
Eh?
Yes. Yeah.
When you open all this road, nowhere for criminal to hide.
Not
say
true.
They go break pipeline. Because everywhere go they open. It could help the country also.
Not true.
But there's no political will
to do all this. Not true. Everything where you talk, it gets sense well. We understand everything and the matter they straight well. And it can't show say 10 years after we this matter been shelle, now in the matter still be like this. And we understand, we know say everything and we press everything go they cajard. Thank you, Ambassador, for your time.
Madam, thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you so much. Make you get better day.
Thank you.